Hi, welcome back to the Armenian Museum of America. I'm Gary Lind-Sinanian, curator, and I'd like to share some more objects from my collection with you. Today we're going to look at this. This is a soap container. This is the metal, the handle to carry it. To look at the inside, I hope you can you see the holes in there? Maybe I should put some. Okay. The holes in a drain, because once a week people would go to the bathhouse. They have certain days that are men's days, certain days that are ladies' days. When you go there, you'll carry your soap. This is traditional soap, and this will allow it to drain out so it doesn't get all smushy on you with the water on it. And this one is a very elaborate as far as the bottom of it goes. It's another one here. You see, it's had a bit of damage. And this one is very simple on the inside as far as the holes. These would be family heirlooms passed down from generation to generation. They went to the bathhouse. It wasn't just taking a bath. Say on ladies' day, all the ladies would get together and they'd all go together, and all the females of the household. It would be an occasion the whole day. They're going out to a picnic. You bring food with you and entertainment and all, and you spend the whole day in the bathhouse chatting up with all the other neighbors, sharing gossip and whatnot. So it's very important as a social activity. It was also important as a means of checking out the young ladies in the community, because if you had a young male, a son or a nephew who was getting old enough to marry, you want to find a bride for him. The weddings were all, marriages were all prearranged. Weddings, the boy and the girl really had no say in it. It was the parents that said, or the grandparents, etc., you're going to marry so-and-so. That was it. That's the way they ran things. And so when you go to the bathhouse, you would get a chance to look at the girls. You could check them out to make sure that they were physically, there weren't any abnormalities, deformations, etc. And also look at them physically to see if they were like a sturdy stock. Could they bear children? Because that was the most important thing for the marriage, was you wanted lots and lots of kids. And you had lots of kids. You had huge families. When you bring things to the bathhouse, you would also bring an object like this. This looks rather lethal as far as the top of it. This is a mirror. And you put this mirror here with the face down so the mirror will not get broken. You're not liable to step on it with this kind of a top to it. Of course, it's also, if you sit on it, it would be quite injurious. And they, if you fell on it, this could kill you. I mean, it certainly wouldn't meet an OSHA inspection as far as that goes. But people didn't think about those things at the time. And so this was the handle of the mirror like that, and to pick up the mirror. In this one, it didn't work. Somebody broke the mirror inside it. We have others that have the mirror in them, but those are in display right now on some of the exhibit cases. But this is the kind of thing that you would bring to the bathhouse also. And as I said, be very aware of it so you don't injure yourself with it. And this also brings up another issue about children, is that infant mortality or child mortality is pretty high. You had lots of children, but a lot of them didn't survive till adulthood. They died in accidents, sometimes illness, sometimes accidents. These were basically working families, and everybody worked, including the children. And the work could be dangerous, and so you have accidents and people died. But that was a society. It was basically a peasant society. And that was not, they made no provisions for safety. That just wasn't part of the mindset. The work is work. You just got to do this. And they did. And you lived and you died. The Armenian Museum is here to share stories with you. Sometimes not always the most upbeat, as it were. Thank you for joining us, and I hope that you join us again. Until then, please stay safe.